Greetings to everyone out there and welcome back to Around the Clock. And during today's presentation for the DLC expansion pass for Pokemon Sword and Shield, the Pokemon Company announced a lot of huge changes coming to Pokemon Sword and Shield, plus new updates and so much more. So let's get right into it. Of course, we got our first look at the Crown Tundra DLC coming to the game, which showed us the brand new areas, the different Pokemon that you will encounter within the Crown Tundra, along with brand new accessories and different types of gear for your characters to go along with this brand new freezing area called the Crown Tundra. Now, to go along with this, a lot of new updates have been announced for Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield, and the first one includes all the legendary Pokemon from the past Pokemon games are back within Pokemon Sword and Shield, and I think a lot of people would be very surprised to see this. I know this was a big complaint at the beginning of the game, but yes, all legendary Pokemon from past games are back within these two games. Also, the Crown Tundra DLC will be released to the public on Thursday, October 22nd, 2020. Also, two new versions of Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield, which will include the Pokemon expansion passes for each game, will be released to the public via retail stores on Friday, November 6, 2020. And as you can see down there at the bottom right hand corner, it states this. Note, the bundle includes the Pokemon Sword or Pokemon Shield base game, as well as the corresponding expansion pass together on a single game card. The content in the bundle is the same content you would get if you had purchased the base game and the corresponding expansion pass separately. So, of course, I know a lot of people already thought that this was going to happen, that we'll get two fully loaded Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield games with the corresponding DLCs, and they've done this. And I think this is really good, especially for people who have not experienced this game already. You get the DLC right there within the game, and at the time that I'm recording this video, there isn't any price for this as of yet for these two games. I'm not too sure. I don't think that it would be $59.99. If they are, then that's a great deal, but I think they're going to be a little bit more than this, being that the expansion pass DLC is included. And to go along with this, 8 free hats for Ash's Pikachu will be available for free via different passwords that will be issued out by the Pokemon Company, and the first one is the one that you see on your screens here for the original cap for Pikachu. And the next update that the Pokemon Company announced for the Pokemon Sword and Shield games is a huge one, because they announced that for the existing Pokemon that you have already caught within Pokemon Go, can be transferred to Pokemon Sword and Shield by the way of the Pokemon Home app. And there are certain Pokemon that you can't transfer over. I think there's special Pokemon that they haven't announced as of yet, but I think that this is really cool. I know a lot of people still play Pokemon Go, and they have caught a lot of Pokemon within this game. So being able to transfer these Pokemon within Pokemon Sword and Shield is really cool. And as a special bonus, I believe for the first time that you transfer your Pokemon from Pokemon Go to Pokemon Sword and Shield, you get a really cool special Melmetal that can Gigantamax. And this is the first time that a Melmetal will be able to do this within Pokemon Sword and Shield. So this is a big deal. Now, at the moment, you won't be able to do any of this transferring from Pokemon Go to Pokemon Sword and Shield, but new details of this will be coming within the year, so I'm pretty sure they have to work on this to make sure everything as far as the transferring process is ironed out. And this is really cool, man. Something to look forward to if you play Pokemon Go and Pokemon Sword and Shield. So, hey, this is huge, and I think that a lot of people will like this. And finally, a brand new Star Tournament mode is coming to Pokemon Sword and Shield, and I think this is cool as well. This allows you to team up with different trainers in this cool multiplayer mode to battle it out, and I think this, along with all the other updates that were announced today, were very good additions coming to the game, and some of these updates are what fans have wanted since day one. Alright everyone, that's gonna do it for this video. What are your thoughts on all these brand new updates coming to Pokemon Sword and Shield, plus the brand new retail versions which will include the DLC expansion passes for each game? Please let me know down in the comment section below. And if you like this video, make sure to hit that like button, because it really does help out the channel and gives exposure to other people who do not know about Around the Clock. Also, please share this video as well. If you're not already subscribed, be sure to hit that subscribe button as well as the notification bell so that you don't miss out on new and daily Nintendo news content. Right here at Around the Clock, we're here, we focus on Nintendo gaming news around the clock. Catch you guys in the next one.